6 minute English
from BBC Learning English.
Hello, I'm Neil.
Hello, I'm Dan. Neil, aren't you going to say the welcome to 6 minute English bit?
Maybe. How's your mood today, Dan? Feeling happy?
Oh, yes, very happy. I've just had lunch. What about you?
Well, to be honest, I haven't had the chance to eat yet, and it's making me a bit grumpy.
Why haven't you eaten?
Well, I was doing some research for today's topic, which is all about feeling angry when you're hungry. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yes. We're talking about being hangry. It's quite a new word, isn't it? A combination of hungry and angry.
Yes, and hangry is our topic. But before we learn more about it, here's today's quiz. English has quite a few words which are made by joining two different words together, like hangry. For example, brunch, motel, Brexit. What do we call these words? Are they A, suitcase words, B, portmanteau words, or C, backpack words?
Well, I think I know this one, so I'll keep the answer to myself. Don't want to give away any spoilers. What I do want to know is if hanger is a real thing, or is it just something that's been made up by grumpy people, like you?
Let's hear from Sophie Medlin, who is a lecturer in nutrition and dietetics at King's College London. Is hanger a real thing, and where does the word come from?
We've long recognised that hunger leads to irritability in science, but the wonderful world of social media has merged the two words for us, and now we know it as hanger.
So, is hanger a real thing, and where does she say the word comes from?
According to Medlin, it is a real thing. She says that science has recognised that hunger leads to irritability. Irritability is a noun which means being easily annoyed, not in a good mood.
And she says that it was the wonderful world of social media that joined the two words together. She used the verb merge, merge meaning join together.
I know social media is responsible for many things, but the word hangry actually appeared in the 1990s, so a little before the arrival of social media. But it's certainly true that social media has made it more prominent.
Me, right now, hashtag hangry. Let's listen to that clip again.
We've long recognised that hunger leads to irritability in science, but the wonderful world of social media has merged the two words for us, and now we know it as hanger.
So, now we know that hanger is a real thing, let's learn a bit more about it. Why does it happen? Why do we get angry when we're hungry? Here's Sophie Medlin again.
As the blood sugars drop, we increase our cortisol and adrenaline, so our kind of fight or flight hormones. And those have an impact on our brain. And the neuropeptides, the things that control our brain, the chemicals in our brain, the ones that trigger for hunger are the same ones that trigger for anger and also for rage and impulsive type behaviour. So that's why you get that sort of same response.
So it's all to do with blood sugar, isn't it?
Yep, it seems so. When we're hungry, the level of sugar in our blood is lower, and this causes an increase in particular hormones. Hormones are the chemicals we make in our bodies that control certain biological and psychological functions.
The hormones released when we are hungry are the same as our fight or flight hormones. They are the hormones the body uses to prepare us to either fight or run away from a dangerous situation.
When these hormones are increased, it can cause anger and rage. Rage is another word for being very angry.
And when we're angry, we can behave impulsively. Impulsive behaviour is when we do things without thinking, without considering the consequences.
So, when we're hungry, the same emotions can run through us. We can be angry and make poor decisions. And that is hanger.
Which brings us nicely to our quiz question. What do we call words, like hanger, that are made by joining two different words together? Now, you said you knew the answer, Dan.
I did.
What was it?
Portmanteau words.
And you are absolutely correct. The answer is portmanteau words. Congratulations if you knew that.
I did.
All right then, smarty pants. No need to boast.
I can see that you're still a little bit hangry, Neil.
Yes, I'm hungry and that's making me angry. But I think I can hold on to get through a review of the rest of today's vocabulary.
Well, we also had the noun irritability, meaning getting annoyed very easily. just like you.
Don't! Just don't! Or I might just merge my fist with your face.
Ouch! Yes, merge, meaning join different things together. I can see your fight or flight hormones are kicking in. Those chemicals in the body that prepare us for aggression or escape.
I haven't quite reached rage yet. This was another of our words, rage, and it means a state of being very, very angry.
Our last word was impulsive. This is an adjective to describe when we do things without really thinking about them. We just do them without any control and without thinking about the consequences.
Now, I'm off. I'm starving. I've got to eat before I do something impulsive. That's it for this program. For more, find us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and our YouTube pages, and of course our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where you can find all kinds of other programs and videos and activities to help you improve your English. Thank you for joining us, and goodbye.
Bye-bye.
6 Minute English
from BBC Learning English.